Class 3 for your English grammar. We are in chapter 8 and today we will learn about the using have, has, had. Using have, has, had. You have already learned how to use has and have in sentence. Let us look at it again. Okay. Here 1 till 6 have and has an apple. You can see in this way we can use. Okay. We use have and has when you want to say what a person, an animal or a thing possesses or own. For example, I have a blue desk, she has a green pencil. Okay, we use have and has when we want to say what a person, animals, things possess, means own. Okay, what he has or she has. Okay, I want you to write this definition in your Excel copy for your future reference. Number D. Now use the word given in a table to make sentence of your own. Okay, 1 till 6 you can see in different pencil shape I have done. The matching you can do it by yourself. Okay, you can just see it here. Have, has and had are also used to show the relationship characteristics, qualities and experience. They are also used to talk about what people do or get and things people eat or drink. For example, he has a very pleasant voice. Quality: they have 3 daughters. Relationship: we had a good time at park. Experience: I like to have some milk in the morning. What people eat or drink. Okay, we can use have, has and had also to show relationship characteristics and qualities and experience. Okay, we can also use to talk about what people do or get and the things people eat or drink. Okay, we use has and have and had. Now read these pairs of sentence. I have a fever. I had a fever last month. She has a fever. She had a fever yesterday. We have a test. We had a test last week. They have a test. They had a test yesterday. In each pair, the first sentence talks about something that is taken place in the present, so we are using have and has. Okay, in first sentence we can see that it talks about something that is taking place, okay, present, whereby we use have and has. Okay, let's see next page. The second sentence talks about something that took place in the past. Here we use had. Okay, in second state we use had. It talks about the past that have already happened. Okay, and in that case we use had. Had is used in past tense of has and have. Had is used in a past tense of has and have. Number E, complete the table and one is done for you. Okay, we have to write the present and the past. You can see I have done it for you. I hope you will understand. Using was and were. Read this sentence with was and were. I was happy and you were happy. We were happy. He was running a race. They were singing a song. Okay, you can see here. When talking about an action that took place in past, we use was and were. We use was with singular noun and were with plural noun. We also use was for the collective noun. For example, the team was playful. The litter of puppies was very cute. Okay. Well, talking of action that took place in past. Okay, the action, the things that we do in the past, we use was and were. Okay, and remember, we use was in singular noun and were in plural noun. And even we can use was, was in collective noun. collective noun also. Okay, number F. Tick the correct sentence in this pair. You have to tick the correct sentence in this pair. Okay, you can see here, just like I have done it for you. I hope you write it down. And here also. And number G. Fill in the blanks with using am, is, or are. Okay, you can see I have done it for you. And number H. Fill in the blanks using am, is, or are with ing form. The verb given in the bracket one has been done for you. We have to fill in the blanks using am, is, or are with ing form. From the verb given in the bracket. Okay, you can see I have done it for you. Number I. Choose the correct word to fill in the blanks. Okay, you have to choose the correct words and fill in the blanks with the help of bracket. And let's see next page. Let's see here. Okay, I hope this is the end of the end of our chapters 8, and in next video we'll learn about the chapter 9 adverb. Till then, take care and complete your work, and see you soon.